President, please be seated.
Le Président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is back in session.
Reprise de l'audience.
The chamber gives the floor to the international deputy
co-prosecutor
to resume his lines of questioning.
Pour qu'il
you may now proceed.
Continue à poser des questions aux témoins. Vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, witness.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Monsieur le témoin. Bonjour.
Other than comrade Met.
Outre le camarade Met.
Coming to the airfield on a number of occasions.
Il s'est rendu
were there any
d'aviation à plusieurs reprises.
Other more senior Khmer Rouge leaders
hauts dirigeants
that attended the airfield that you saw?
Rendu sur ce terrain dont vous avez parlé.
When they came to visit, I could see them got off the vehicle,
visite,
and I do not recognize those people because I was staying far from the place where vehicle stopped.
Assez loin de l'endroit où leur véhicule s'arrêtait.
You were asked in your interview on E35278 whether you saw senior leaders come to the airport, and this is at 0029-2824, Khmer 0028-7528, and French 0035-5865. You were asked this question, did you see any Khmer Rouge leaders come to visit the airport construction site at Kampong Chenang?
Non, on vous demande si vous avez vu
you said, in early 1977, I saw a convoy entering through the access road to the airport construction site. At that time, I saw Kyu Sampan and Yang Sari visit the airport with armored vehicles and escorting many soldiers. I did not know the purposes of Kyu Sampan or Yang Sari's visit, but I saw Levi and other chiefs at the airport construction site with them. I saw Met coming to visit the airport construction site once or twice a month. Does that refresh your memory? You said earlier that the statement was correct.
Vous avez dit que votre
did you see Kyu Sampan and Yang Sari come to the airport or the airfield construction site, or did you not?
Answer, as I stated earlier, I was staying
dit,
in a far distance. I could not see them well.
Je n'ai pas bien
they
pu
came
les voir.
To visit the airport construction site.
The
senior people came to
c'était
visit the work site in order to, you know, try to see the airplanes.
Pour essayer de voir les avions.
Thank you. And when you told the investigator that you saw Kyu Sampan and Yang Sari, did you in fact see them at the construction site or not?
Those particular people. Vu sur le chantier ou pas? Je parle de ces deux personnes bien précises.
Answer.
Réponse.
At that time, many people came off from the vehicles, and the one who was close to me told me that they are senior. They were senior people coming to visit the construction work site. I was staying behind others, so I could not see who they were.
Donc je n'ai pas vu de qui il s'agissait.
Did someone tell you that it was Kyu Sampan
question.
And Yang Sari that visited,
vous a-t-il dit
or
que
did you just assume that?
Visite, ou l'avez-vous présumé, supposé?
Answer. People who were standing close to me, they said they saw them,
and
I was staying in a far distance. I could not see, and I was not tall enough to see them.
Je n'étais pas assez grand.
And 3 days later, airplane landed at the work site for the test.
L'avion a atterri sur ce site.
Did those people that told you that they arrived, did they tell you that it was Q Sampan and Yang Sari,
or did they just say it was senior leaders? Ou vous ont-elles dit qu'il s'agissait de hauts dirigeants?
Answer. I was told their names and the two names were mentioned, and I was told that these senior people came to visit the work site and to see the airplanes.
Et qu'elles venaient voir les avions.
And can you provide a time period? Was
question,
that 1976,
1977? 1978. Pourriez-vous nous donner une idée de la date?
Answer.
Réponse.
Could not recall it, whether it was in 1977 or
78.
The plans were applied at the time for the test.
Thank you.
At
the work site, a lot of work had to be done to build the airport. How was that information communicated?
J'aimerais savoir comment les communications relatives ont été faites, comment les informations ont été communiquées.
Answer. I could not
réponse.
Understand. I do not understand your question.
Je n'ai pas
please
très bien
repeat
compris
it.
Votre question. Pourriez-vous répéter
Thank you. It was a bit general. So perhaps if I put to you what you
question.
Told the investigator as to how information was conveyed from the person in charge
qui étaient transmises par les personnes responsables
at the construction site
sur le
to
chantier.
Others. And I refer to
E3-5278
and English 0029-2825, Khmer 0028-7530 and French 0035-5867. You were asked this question. What kinds of meetings were held at Krang Lu Airport construction site? Who convened the meeting? What were the contents of the meeting? What were the decisions of those meetings? You answered, they held a weekly meeting and chaired either by Levi or Yang. The meeting discussed about construction plan and attended by chiefs of different units
et les chefs
at
des
the construction site.
Puis les
then the chiefs disseminated and enforced those decisions in their groups. Does that refresh your memory as to how information was passed down from Levi, the top manager, to the different units?
Answer.
Réponse.
They were sent to Ta Ying, and Ta Ying
would à Ta Ying.
Divide them into sections. Some
Ta
people
Ying
were
les
put in
sections.
Wires connection section, and some were put in the section which was in charge of erecting the poles.
Qui s'occupait des fils, des connexions, et une
about how many different units or work groups were there to be able to build the airfield?
Quand étaient-ils des sections mises en place pour mettre en place pour construire cet aéroport?
In I could see two divisions.
J'ai vu qu'il y avait deux
and,
divisions.
And there were other brigades.
Et d'autres brigades.
And I could recall that there were two divisions.
Mais je me souviens
there.
Qu'il y avait deux divisions sur place.
One division from Air Force.
Une division des forces aériennes.
One division
et une
from
division
artillery.
D'artillerie.
Section. So there were two sections from divisions. And I recall that there were other units taken from other brigades or divisions, but I did not know where they were from.
Je ne sais pas d'où elles venaient.
Thank you. You said that you knew Comrade Matt reasonably well, more so than others of your level in the army. I would like to quote to you what he stated at a meeting on the 9th of October 1976 with other division secretaries and deputy secretaries, and the number is E3/13, and the English is 0094-0350, Khmer 0005-2411, and French 0033-980. And he said at this meeting, when they were asked to comment on the enemy situation, he said, the enemy will not be able to do anything for as long as our military is politically hard and clean. It is imperative to strengthen the party politically, ideologically, and organizationally. It is imperative to dare to absolutely to conduct purges.
Mener des purges.
At the airport were unit chiefs and other supervisors there responsible to look out to see if there were enemies in the ranks, in the workers at the airport, at the airfield site.
Devait-il voir s'il y avait des ennemis au sein des soldats qui intervenaient sur le chantier de l'aéroport?
Answer.
Réponse.
It is difficult to say.
Il m'est difficile de vous le dire.
If unit chief or office chief hated
si les chefs d'unité,
us, he or she could say anything he or she wanted. He or she could say that we betrayed Anka. Everyone was afraid of these people.
Tout le monde avait peur de ces gens.
And we were not only afraid of the chief of the office, but also other higher officials.
Nous avions peur également des autres dirigeants.
I would like to put to you another
question.
Matter from another divisional meeting between the secretaries and deputy secretaries of the divisions on the 1st of March 1977, and this is
E3/807,
and it's at English 0093-3834. I think we have an objection.
President, please hold on. International Deputy Co-Prosecutor, you may not proceed, Mr. Copé.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yes, I do have an objection, assuming it's the same kind of question to the witness that was just posed earlier. I think it's time that we put this witness into perspective. He gave testimony as to his functioning. He was a messenger. He was a soldier in a division of about 5,000 to 6,000 men. He was on the very lowest levels of this division. He's now being asked about a meeting between division commanders and vice commanders. He is in no position whatsoever to give any credible evidence as to what the top of the division is negotiating or talking about to other leaders of divisions. Where the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea at one point had about 60,000 to 70,000 men. He is somebody on a very low level, and he cannot possibly say anything intelligent as to meetings of the top military leaders of these divisions. So I think there's no point in asking this witness these kinds of questions. So I object.
Your Honours, I don't propose to ask him questions about what occurred at the meeting, that at the divisional meeting he clearly wasn't there. But what I'm asking him, or what I will ask him, is whether or not the policy that was discussed at the divisional meeting was passed down through to the commanders, through the deputy to Levai, to the worksite meetings. It's to provide evidence of policy at the airfield. Now, I think when we listened to the answer to the previous question, he wasn't asked about the divisional meeting, but he was asked about the policy. And it was quite clear that this witness is a little reluctant to talk, but given some more factual details, he does provide more information about what's happening at the airfield, not in the divisional meeting.
Sur le terrain d'aviation, non pas ce qui s'est passé au cours de la réunion.
President,
le président,
it is too quick to raise your objection, Mr. Copé. The co-prosecutor has not yet put specific question to this witness. Witness, you are instructed to listen to the question clearly, and also Counsel Copé, please wait for the question whether or not you will have objection. You may not proceed, International Deputy Co-Prosecutor.
Thank you. And the French ERN was 0032-3922, and the Khmer was 0005-2304. At that meeting, on the 1st of March 1977, Comrade Met said, it was said that there was a contradiction because the chairman of a platoon had made a severe criticism when referring to a grenade being tied to kill a comrade. He then states, it's obviously obvious that a number of elements who had previously arrested really are enemy elements. More than 50 no goods have been sent to S21. He then states there can only be reliability if five more company secretaries are removed. My question to you is, at the meetings at the airfield, were there similar discussions about the removal of enemies from the military ranks? This one occurred at a higher level, but at the airfield, were there similar discussions about the removal of enemies?
When there were big meetings,
lorsqu'il y avait de grandes réunions,
the big meeting would relay the message, and we also had joined the small meetings.
Nous devions également participer we à were instructed
to listen well to the instructions.
Nous avions pour ordre de bien écouter les consignes.
And we were warned not to betray the revolution.
Nous prévenait bien qu'il ne fallait pas
in the meeting, we were told that the upper level told us to well behave and to follow the lines of the revolution.
That
is what we were told
voilà
in our meetings. And if we betray the revolution,
et
we
were
killed.
De la révolution, nous risquons d'être exécutés.
And how were you asked to follow
the revolution? Suivre la révolution?
Were you asked to look out for enemies at the work site?
Des ennemis sur le chantier?
Answer, no, we were not asked to look out for enemies. We were instructed to be responsible for the tasks and the assignments.
Responsable des tâches qui nous étaient confiées.
And in the meetings, it was said that the people from the East zone had some of the tendency, and I was told to get all of them to help to chop the trees.
Il a été demandé que ces personnes
and in the meetings, we were also told that to be careful and to work hard to avoid any disappearance. In that period, there were disappearances.
Ah, c'était pas qu'il y avait
and we were told to help each other in our work.
Nous a dit également qu'il fallait que nous entraidions.
You said that after seeing the or hearing of the sounds of screaming and and the smell of dead bodies and the general atmosphere at the airfield was that the workers were asking themselves when their day would come. That is the day we would be killed or died. Was there a real atmosphere of fear at the airfield?
Pourriez-vous nous dire s'il y avait une ambiance de crainte, si la peur était très présente sur le chantier?
Answer, yes, everyone was afraid and terrified.
Tout le monde avait peur. Tout le monde était terrorisé.
Everyone and I, nowhere that we were working, were afraid of such occurrence.
Tout le monde avait peur.
Had you ever been to we referred to S21 when Met said 50 no goods would be sent to S21.
Avait dit que plus de 50 mauvaises.
Do you know what S21 was?
Saviez-vous où était S21?
When you were at the airfield.
Lorsque vous étiez sur le chantier.
Answer, I did not know.
Non,
I heard
pas.
People mention about S21, but I myself did not know.
You said in your statement that you were arrested and sent to S21, and then shortly after you escaped. Do you know whether that in fact was S21, or could it have been another security center?
Answer. What I knew
réponse.
Is that the place was Tulslang.
Je sais qu'il s'agissait de Tulslang.
And I heard people mention about S21 afterwards.
J'ai entendu des gens en parler de S21.
So I did not know S21, but I knew
Tulslang
school.
L'école de Tulslang.
When you were arrested,
question.
Were you placed in cells?
Avez-vous été placé dans une cellule?
Or were you just taken into the grounds of that area? Were you put inside, or were you just taken into the grounds and then you escaped?
Si vous avez été amené dans l'enceinte ou si vous avez été vraiment enfermé dans une cellule avant de pouvoir vous échapper?
Answer, Upon arrival at that place, I was kicked and I fell off the vehicle.
Je suis tombé du véhicule.
I was taken into a toilet. One guy took me into a toilet near that place, and I was warned not to flee.
Près de là, et l'on m'a averti qu'il ne fallait pas que je m'enfuie.
Afterward, this guy showed me a piece of paper of how to flee.
Un morceau de papier.
And
he
tried to help me flee the place, and I had that piece of paper as the direction to run away.
Ce papier pour
and
à
I was given meal, and the meal was put into the container, and I could flee the place.
Et j'ai pu m'enfuir ainsi.
It was around 2 a.m. at night that I could make an escape.
So is it the case that you arrived in the dark and you left in the dark the same evening or night? Is that correct?
Answer, it was in the dark. We could not see anything.
On ne pouvait rien voir.
And I had cuts on my face, and I had a blindfold. I was blindfolded
J'avais
as well.
Les yeux bandés.
I was, as I said, I was kicked and I fell
On
off
frappé,
the vehicle.
Comme je l'ai dit,
I
je
could
suis
see
du véhicule.
A flagpole, and I could see other two poles attached with the string attached.
Et deux poteaux attachés
the guy asked me why I was arrested, and I was asked to stay in the toilet. And after that, he gave me rice, meal, and put in the container, and I could flee with that kind of meal.
Thank you. I just have a few more questions, and then I'll finish. At the airfield, you witnessed many people dying as a result of the conditions.
Vu si beaucoup de personnes sont mortes?
You witnessed many people being arrested and taken away in trucks.
Beaucoup de personnes se faire emmener dans des
you
camions.
Witnessed trucks arriving up at a tree
des camions arriver
near where you worked on a number of occasions and heard screaming, and then later smelt decomposing bodies. Why didn't you do anything to stop what was going on?
Mr. President, that was a nice summary, but I never heard the witness say that people were dying at the airfield because of working conditions. He described the hearing of screaming, which I think is at a site 3 kilometers away from the airport, close to possible the transportation house. We have not established at all that these screams have anything to do with people working at the airfield. Maybe they were people who lived in the west zone in sector 31. So this part of that summary of the prosecution doesn't reflect, at least in our view, the testimony of this witness this morning.
Your Honor, as you remember, I read out the summary of I read out the portion of his statement where he exactly said that people did die from conditions, people did die from suicides, people did die from because of overwork, and he agreed with that. And so I put that to him, and as we know, this witness has said that where he saw the killings, that was 3 kilometers from the airfield by the transportation office, which related to the airfield. So my summary was accurate, Your Honor, even though it was put to him from his statement, that's what he agreed to. Okay, so we've lost a bit of momentum, but if you can tell us why you didn't do anything. You heard and saw these killings and arrests on a frequent basis. Why didn't you do anything?
How could I stop that? Even I myself could not stop working. I was waiting for the days to come for myself. Everyone was afraid and was terrified. The regime at that time was not like that in the current situation. And during this time, and nowadays, we can discuss and talk to each other and negotiate. And in that period, we would be afraid of being accused of enemies. If we were accused of being enemies, we would be arrested. I did not commit any a mistake at that time, and I was accused that I was the one who transported the rice for the enemies, and as a result, I was arrested. So I could not stop what was happening at that place.
So are you saying that if you told Levi or told Commander Met about these arrests, about these deaths, that you would be accused of being an enemy if you raised this problem with them?
Si vous aviez soulevé ce problème avec eux.
Even
réponse.
I myself. When I start help from five people whom I knew at the division,
moi-même,
none of them dared to give me a safety way out,
and only mate
actually was willing to help me, otherwise I would be dead.
Sinon, je ne serais pas là aujourd'hui, je serais mort.
Thank you, Your Honor. I finished my questions.
Accusation. Merci. J'en ai terminé.
President, thank you. The chamber now hands the floor to the lead co-lawyers for civil parties to put questions to this witness, and you may proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour à tous.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Je cède la parole à ma consoeur, Tisrina.
I give the floor to my colleague, Tisrina.
President, yes, the chamber grants your request. Tisrina, thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Mr. President, your honors, everyone in and around the courtroom, and good afternoon, Mr. Witness. My name is Tisrina. I am a lawyer for civil parties, and I have some questions to put to you to seek your clarification regarding the events took place at the Kampong Chinang Airport work site. And my first question is the following.
Ma première question est la suivante.
When was the Kampong Chinang Airport project started,
and when was it concluded, if you can recall? Et quand s'est-il terminé, si vous vous en souvenez?
Answer, I do not remember it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
It has been several years. I cannot recall the exact date when the project was initiated. And although I had been transferred elsewhere, I believe the project was completed when the Vietnamese troops arrived.
Question.
And when you started your work at the Kampong Chinang Airport work site, did
Was there any announcement that the project would last for a year or two? Was there such an announcement at the start of the project? And so, no, there was no such an announcement. I was told to lead people to work at the site, and there was no such announcement at all.
Aucune telle annonce.
And the work was ongoing at the time that I worked there.
Se poursuivait, était en cours lorsque moi j'y travaillais.
Question. Did you know at the time whose idea was it to build the airport work site? Did you hear a similar account from your superior, that is Louvain, that who actually came up with the idea to build an airport in Kampong Chnam, and what its purpose was?
Answer.
I heard Mate said that the airport was meant for military operation, that is for the Air Force operation
militaire,
from the parachuting troops.
Pour les troupes parachutistes.
Question. I'd like now to ask you questions about the change of command at the Kampong Chnam Airport work site. And since you were there from the beginning of the project, as you may be familiar with the change of command and as well as the laborers there.
Et également, peut-être connaissez-vous.
Can you tell the court how many laborers were there at the work site and what was the chain of command like? Answer. At the beginning, there was Song and
Jane
and Louvain.
Et
and a handful of others who were in the leadership role, and I was also there to bring in the logistics. And later on, we also received some Chinese technical advisors, and we were in a group of the first batch to arrive at the work site.
Est arrivé le premier groupe sur
question.
Le site de travail.
For Louvain, Song and Matt, did they have clear, distinctive roles or duties at the airport work site?
Sur le site?
Answer. It was made to assign the tasks to various other cadres, for example, those who were assigned to measure the terrain, or those who were assigned to cut trees, or those who were assigned to uproot trees, or to break rocks. So assignments were made to various units. And after the assignments were made, those units would engage their respective tasks. I myself was assigned to lead them in doing a terrain measurement and to accompany the Chinese delegation. I did not have any other specific tasks than that.
Pas d'autres tâches spécifiques que celle-là.
Question. I'd like now to ask you about the working conditions at the airport project website.
Sur le chantier de construction d'aéroport.
When soldiers were brought in from two divisions, as you stated this morning, to work at the airport site,
pour qu'ils viennent travailler sur le site de l'aéroport,
how was the working and living conditions like?
Comment
for example, were
de
adequate
exemple,
shelter provided?
Y avait-il des abris adéquats qui étaient fournis?
Answer, no.
Réponse, non.
It was dependent on their respective units. They had to build their old sleeping quarter. It was a makeshift type of a shelter that they had to build. And each unit was responsible for building its own sleeping quarter for their workers.
Dortoir pour ses ouvriers.
Question. Did they stay day and night at the work site while they were working there, or they had to return to stay elsewhere?
Ou retournaient ou rentraient-ils quelque part?
Answer. At that time, there were no houses for those workers.
À cette époque, il n'y avait pas de maison.
They stayed with their unit. For example, for a unit of 50 workers, they would stay within their respective unit. Or a group of 10 workers would stay within their own its own group.
Ensemble.
And the same thing applies to the 100-man unit.
Pour les unités de 100 personnes.
And for those, for example, if they were assigned to break
Par
rocks,
exemple,
they would stay at the rock-breaking work
roche,
site.
Ils devaient rester sur le site où la roche
and
était
likewise, the one who connects the electricity cable
même,
would stay within its respective
de
unit.
Les câbles électriques
there were no wives or children to accompany them at the work site. Question. You
Question.
Mentioned about a rock-breaking unit,
vous avez parlé d'une unité chargée
and
de
you said the same thing
roche,
this morning, and
vous
there was another section
matin.
For digging the ground or for clearing the terrain or uprooting trees.
De nettoyer, défricher, déraciner les arbres.
What Which section that had to endure the hardest working conditions at the work site?
Qui s'occupait du labeur le plus dur sur le site?
Answer, it was the rock breaking unit.
Réponse, c'était l'unité chargée
the women
de
group
briser
and another group which had to locate roots of
Et
all kinds of trees, including palm trees. They had to to locate those roots and had to clear the terrain and there had to be no root or anything left on the ground. That was the hardest section as well as the one for the women. However, for those who had to dig the soil, that part was not really the hardest one.
Ce n'était pas la partie la plus difficile.
Question. So the rock-breaking unit and
Donc,
the women's unit faced the hardest working condition. And what kind of workforce were assigned to these two units? Were they ordinary workers or were they
Et
considered to be offenders committing some kind of mistakes? Either it was a minor mistake or a serious mistake.
Qu'il s'agisse d'un crime grave ou d'un crime mineur.
Answer. It was
Réponse.
The general workforce, and it was the unit itself who assigned its own workforce to engage in various tasks. At that time, everyone was afraid of everyone else, and everyone was minding his or her own business. And the same thing applied to those who worked at various other sections, and not just for the rock-breaking unit or for the women's unit. Everyone was so afraid that one day, the day of the date would arrive.
Qu'un jour, le
and
jour des morts
every
arrive.
Member of every unit failed the same way.
De toute l'unité, le membre de toutes les unités avait le même sentiment.
Questioned and through your experience working there,
d'après votre
did you ever see any worker
avez-vous
falling down or died from overwork or exhaustion or from a work-related incident,
ou de tout autre incident dû au
or whether they They were wounded from any other sources?
Oui, y avait-il des blessés dus à une quelconque source?
Answer. It was the most terrible working condition for the
réponse.
Two units that I just mentioned.
Pour les deux unités
we were
que
given
les
watery gruel.
Terribles. On nous donnait
and they had to endure the hard working conditions, in particular for those women.
Travail, surtout les femmes.
And as you imagined,
comme vous pouvez vous l'imaginer,
it would be extremely difficult to uproot all the roots of just a bunch of grass. And you could imagine clearing the whole terrain for the airport field.
Le travail que représentait le défrichage
it was very,
de tout le terrain
a very
de
difficult situation for them.
C'était une situation très difficile pour eux.
And of course, there were work-related incidents, and it
bien
happened
sûr,
every day.
Des incidents liés au travail. Il y en avait tous les jours.
Some of them were injured from
certaines
overwork or exhaustion, from malnutrition.
Travail,
and as for those who work at the rock breaking unit, sometimes the rock failed upon them.
Qui devait percer les roches.
And sometimes, in particular for women, sometimes they were hit by rollers on site. So every day, there was always an accident at the work site.
Question.
From what you described in terms of work-related accidents, can you confirm whether such an accident occurred every day or every 2 days?
Confirmer si ce type d'accident ou d'incident avait lieu
there was no response from the witness. Question.
Il n'y a pas eu de réponse
did such work-related accident happen only at the site you worked, or was everyone working there familiar about such an accident
sur le site,
throughout the work site?
Avait-il connaissance de ce type d'accident?
Answer.
Réponse.
I can only say that, for example, if we were sitting together in a group of three,
si
only three of us would know what happened. If we were sitting in a group of five, only five of us
si
would know what happened, and we did not dare ask about others. And sometimes we knew that one member of the unit was taken by an ambulance or died, and only us would inquire about it, and we did not dare to ask such questions to other workers outside our group.
Question.
Did anyone die on the site?
Sur le chantier?
And people, yes, died in their respective unit,
oui,
in particular those who worked
unités,
at the rock-breaking in the rock breaking unit.
Ceux qui travaillaient dans
when a rock
de briser la roche.
Fell on them, they died, and
lorsque
the body would be taken away by a vehicle.
Dessus,
question.
Ils étaient emmenés par véhicule.
In such a case
question.
Of work-related death,
dans ce cas,
for example, from
dans
rock hitting,
lors d'un décès
did the was the supervisor on the ground aware of what happened, and was there any measure taken to prevent the future happening, and was there any compensation from the management of the work site to those for those who died?
Answer.
During the regime, forget about compensation. If you died, it simply means you died.
Ça voulait tout simplement dire que vous étiez mort.
There's no compensation.
Il n'y avait aucune compensation.
And at the time, the materials and equipment were more important than human lives. For example, if a car
si,
rolled off the road,
une
and then the people or the driver will be accused of delaying the work
de route,
and despite some injuries to the passengers. So the work and the tools were more important than human life. Question. You said this morning on the work site some women were assigned to work. Were those women soldiers or were they civilians?
Étaient-elles aussi des soldats ou étaient-elles des civils?
And all the workers on site were soldiers. There was no civilian. Question. This morning you also said in your response to the co-prosecutor about workers committing suicide. And you also mentioned that in your written record of interview,
dans votre procès-verbal d'audition,
that is document E3/5278. At EN in Khmer 0028-7528 and 2829 and in English 0029-28-24 and in French 0035-5865-266. The co-prosecutor read you a quote about people committing suicide by running into a roller, and most of them were women. And do you know the reason why those women committed suicide by running into a roller? Answer, it was due to starvation and fatigue. And they even had to work while they were sick. So they did not have any hope to hang on to. And the women's group were working close to the operation of heavy machinery, that is close to rollers and bulldozers or excavators. Yes, they were assigned to clean the terrain by picking all routes. All kinds of routes. They had to clean it nicely and carefully, and if it was checked that there was still a root or two on the assigned plot, then they had to redo the ground again. And out of desperation from overwork and from starvation, sometimes they just roll themselves on the ground to be crushed by a roller. Question. Were site supervisors aware of such an incident?
Les superviseurs étaient-ils au courant de ce type d'incident?
Answer, of course, they were aware of that, but no one spoke about it.
Mais personne n'en parlait.
If you died, you
si
simply
vous mouriez,
died.
Eh bien, vous étiez
no one could help another one.
Personne ne pouvait vous aider. Il n'y avait pas
d'entraide. And that is all. That's what happened.
C'est tout. Voilà ce qu'il s'est passé.
Question. Were any measures taken again to prevent desperation by workers, for example, in terms of a lack of food? Was food issue resolved?
Exemple, en termes de nourriture, est-ce que le problème de la nourriture a été
because,
résolu?
As you said, the airport airport website in Kampong Chang was an important project from the point of view of the superior. Was food issue resolved by the upper echelon?
A-t-elle été résolue par l'échelon supérieur?
And there were some sorts of solutions to the food issue.
Il y avait des solutions pour
sometime when
de
there was enough rice to cook, then the gruel we had was rather thick.
Parfois, lorsqu'il y avait suffisamment de food, à manger, alors the fish was brought in from the river. Et il y avait également du poisson qui était amené depuis la rivière.
But it was not abandoned.
It is
very difficult for me to describe about the food situation at the time.
Il est assez difficile pour moi de décrire la situation alimentaire de l'époque.
In your same written record of interview,
question, dans le même document, procès verbal d'audition,
you said that people who came to arrest were those from outside the work site.
Procéder aux arrestations venaient de l'extérieur du chantier.
And you were asked that question by the co-prosecutor, although I am unclear on your response.
Can
you please repeat again? Why such outsiders permitted to enter the work site and to arrest the workers there?
Au chantier à pénétrer sur le site et arrêter des travailleurs.
Could you elaborate on that?
Que pouvez-vous nous dire à ce sujet?
Answer. I think that was the decision determined by a change of a command from the chief of office up to the unit chief, down to the unit chief. They communicate through their radio and maybe through the report. And maybe that decision was more powerful than the decision made at the division level. And to my understanding, the authority of the chief of office was more authoritative than that of the division.
Que celle de la division.
And of course, they maintained their communication through this chain of command via radio.
Était maintenue par cette,
and at that time, even if you use a wrong word, you will be accused of being an enemy. And Mr. President, I don't have any further question for this witness, the counsel. I'd like to cede the floor to my international colleague. President, you may proceed, lead co-lawyer for civil parties.
Vous avez la parole, co-avocate pour les parties civiles.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Mr. President.
Bonjour, Monsieur le témoin. Je m'appelle Marie Giraud, je suis avocate des parties civiles et j'ai quelques très courtes questions à vous poser vu le temps qu'il me reste. Je vais simplement vous demander de préciser certaines choses que je n'ai pas bien comprises dans votre témoignage, notamment de ce matin. Et je voudrais revenir à ce que vous nous avez dit ce matin sur l'endroit où vous dormiez quand vous êtes arrivé sur le chantier. Vous avez parlé de la caserne
Changsari
que vous avez également appelée maison aux cinq étages. Et vous nous avez expliqué ce matin que vous, avec les techniciens chinois et les travailleurs, dormiez dans cette maison et que les nouveaux venus, et j'utilise ici l'expression que j'ai entendue dans la traduction française, les nouveaux venus étaient allés dormir sur le chantier. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris ce que vous avez déclaré ce matin? Et si oui, pouvez-vous expliquer la différence entre les travailleurs qui dormaient dans la maison aux cinq étages et les soldats travailleurs nouveaux venus qui allaient dormir sur le chantier.
So the sleeping place was divided a bit for the newcomers and the one who had been there at the first stage.
Et les gens qui étaient là
and
dès le début.
There were people in different sections, for example, in the in electricity section,
exemple,
in clearing tree, chopping trees. So they would sleep in different places. I was with the Chinese delegation.
J'étais près de la délégation chinoise.
And help those delegates.
J'aidais ces délégués.
And people who were in charge with the electrical wires, they would work in their group. And there were others who were in charge in laying wires and laying the water pipes. So these people were sleeping in at their workplace. They did not come to sleep at the Chansari barracks.
Je vous remercie. Vous avez expliqué tout à l'heure que les soldats qui arrivaient en général par groupe étaient regroupés et chargés de construire eux-mêmes l'endroit où ils allaient dormir. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition? Et est-ce que ces endroits étaient systématiquement à l'intérieur du site de l'aéroport ou parfois pouvaient-ils être à l'extérieur du site?
Answer. Those who were in charge of building the roads were sleeping at their work sites. And for those who transported rocks would stay at their place. And those who were in charge of transporting sand, they would sleep at their quarter. So as I stated, they slept at their own places.
Ces personnes-là travaillaient là, dormaient
so
là où elles
travaillaient. They would sleep in their respective units, sleeping quarters.
Elles dormaient au sein des dortoirs de leur unité respective.
Avez-vous été amené à visiter ces dortoirs?
Visit
et si oui, pouvez-vous nous dire la façon dont ils se présentaient? Est-ce qu'ils étaient très différents d'une unité à l'autre ou est-ce qu'ils étaient en général construits et réalisés de la même manière?
There were halls and they would tie the hammocks and sleep in the hammocks, and at some sleeping quarters had the beds
dans
made of wood.
Il y avait également des lits en bois.
And there were kitchens, the cooking place close by.
Il y avait en outre un endroit où l'on cuisinait, une cuisine.
In that period, there were no proper sleeping places,
mais
so usually workers
les dortoirs
slept
n'étaient pas
in
des
hammocks
dortoirs en tant que tels, et les ouvriers avaient l'habitude de dormir dans des hamacs en tissu.
Je vous remercie. Vous nous avez indiqué tout à l'heure que tous les travailleurs sur le chantier étaient des soldats. Est-ce que toutes ces personnes portaient leur uniforme ou portaient-elles d'autres vêtements?
We had two sets of clothes.
Nous avions
and in the morning we wore a set of clothes, and if it was raining, so we got wet and soaked, and we had to work with that soaked and wet clothes. So as I stated earlier, there were two sets of clothes only for workers. Everyone had the same amount, the same sets of clothes.
S'agissait-il de tenues militaires
so were
ou étaient-ce des vêtements pour les civils autres que des uniformes?
Other than uniforms?
Yes, the military uniform,
oui,
not
uniforme
a civilian
militaire.
Clothes.
Il ne s'agissait pas de vêtements civils.
So they had military uniforms.
Il s'agissait bien d'uniformes militaires.
Je vous remercie. Je voudrais vous faire réagir à une de vos déclarations devant les co-juges d'instruction concernant les personnes qui étaient malades sur le chantier et dont vous avez parlé tant ce matin que cet après-midi. Je vais donc vous lire la question qui vous a été posée à l'époque et la réponse que vous avez formulée, et je vous demanderai des précisions sur les indications que vous aviez données à l'époque aux enquêteurs. Je suis donc sur le document que nous avons cité depuis le début de la journée, E3-62-78, ERN en français 003-55-8-6-6, en anglais 002-928-2-4, en Khmer 00-28-75-29. On vous a posé à l'époque, monsieur le témoin, la question suivante. Où emmenait-on les militaires ouvriers malades? Y avait-il beaucoup de malades? Et quel genre de maladies y avait-il? Et vous avez répondu à l'époque, et je vous cite, les militaires ouvriers malades étaient transportés en voiture pour se faire soigner à Kampongshnan. Chaque jour, il y avait environ 15 malades et la plupart des maladies étaient la malaria et l'épuisement du fait de la sous-alimentation. Il y avait toujours des ambulances en permanence sur ce chantier. Vous souvenez-vous de cette déclaration? Et si oui, pouvez-vous être un petit peu plus précis sur le type de maladie sur le chantier et sur la présence des ambulances dont vous parlez?
Most of them suffered from malaria. For example, my group and I went to Krangskil to chop trees. And we went to Leakongcheung and Tmolbang. There were many insects, so we mostly got malaria. And when we returned to our workplace, there were ambulances where we were taken to the hospital at the zone level if we fell sick.
Les ambulances pouvaient emmener les malades à l'hôpital du
standby to take us to the hospital when we fell sick. Most of us got malaria.
La plupart d'entre nous avons attrapé le paludisme.
For example, people from the east zone, they were assigned to chop trees in the deep forest, and many of them got malaria.
Et la plupart d'entre eux ont attrapé le paludisme.
Je vous remercie. Vous indiquez que certains des soldats, travailleurs, étaient envoyés à l'hôpital quand ils étaient malades. Avez-vous, à l'époque, vu revenir certains de ces travailleurs sur le chantier? Une fois qu'ils partaient à l'hôpital, vous est-il arrivé de les voir revenir pour à nouveau travailler sur le chantier?
Yes. Those who recovered from illness, they would be sent back to the work site. They were not allowed to stay long at the hospital. They would be sent back to the work site. If the sick got recovered, and if they were from the any certain units, they would be sent back to those units after they recovered. There were many of them getting malaria.
Ils reprenaient le travail, mais beaucoup attrapaient le paludisme.
Je vous remercie. Les soldats travailleurs sur le site de l'aéroport étaient-ils surveillés d'une quelconque manière?
There were military group, said the witness, who were walking and standing guard.
Qui déambulaient et qui
this military
la garde.
were from the center. I do not know where this military were from.
Mais je ne sais pas exactement d'où.
They would leave, and they were standing guard in the morning.
Et ils montaient and they la garde were watching le matin.
Workers. They were on the vehicle
and watching over, over us from
that vehicle. I did not know them at that time, and I heard that they were referred to as a military.
À l'époque, mais j'ai entendu dire que c'était des militaires.
Je vous remercie. En plus de ces patrouilles en voiture, y avait-il
patrols,
quelconque surveillance de la part de militaires
à pied qui, se,
qui marchaient sur le site de l'aéroport?
The workers on, the airport work site.
These military men were also walking and watching
ces
over us in the morning.
They
were at
the
work site for a while.
Ils étaient présents sur le chantier pendant longtemps.
And as I stated earlier, they were walking
dit,
sometime, and on some other occasion, they were on a vehicle patrolling the place where people worked.
Et ils effectuaient des patrouilles depuis ces véhicules.
Quand vous alliez dans la forêt avec les hommes dont vous aviez la responsabilité, les hommes de l'Est, comme vous les avez appelés, ces hommes étaient-ils surveillés? Et étiez-vous en charge de surveiller ces hommes?
Charge of watching over these men?
Were there working together. They came in vehicles and many of them passed away. And we were the drivers. And many of us, as the drivers, were also asked to watch over the people from the East Zone.
Nous devions souvent surveiller les gens de la zone Est.
And workers from East Zone were sleeping in their own areas, and they could cook rice to eat.
Et ils faisaient cuire du riz.
Even though we were in the same airfield or work site, we could not have time to chit-chat or make any conversation. We did not have time to ask where we were from.
Nous demander les uns les autres
we only
nous
could ask some little information
nous
from
nous
each other.
Aborder quelques petites informations,
as I stated earlier, we did not have time to discuss, to chit-chat if we happened to make conversation, we would be accused of
et
being
si
insider.
De la sorte, nous aurions pu être accusés d'être des ennemis.
Quand vous dites que beaucoup de personnes de la zone Est sont décédées, est-ce que vous pouvez être un petit peu plus précis? Est-ce qu'ils sont décédés pendant la période où vous étiez chargé de les surveiller? Et si oui, comment le saviez-vous à l'époque?
How did you know that they died back then?
It was later after they went to chop trees, and these people were then put to work in the airfield. So many of them died during that period. During the time that they were sent to chop trees, not many of them died.
Lorsqu'ils ont été envoyés abattre des arbres, ils n'ont pas été très nombreux à mourir.
And I could notice that one person disappeared every month from units, from their units. And I also noticed that many of my colleagues disappeared
j'ai
as well.
J'ai vu également que beaucoup de mes collègues avaient disparu.
Une fois que le travail de coupe de bois a été terminé par les travailleurs soldats de l'Est, savez-vous à quelles tâches ont-ils été affectés?
Do you know to which other tasks they were then assigned?
Ils sont revenus travailler sur le chantier du terrain d'aviation, certains transporter du sable, d'autres construction.
And some others were tasked with building fences after they returned from chopping down trees.
Une fois qu'ils en avaient fini avec la coupe des arbres.
And when they returned to work in the airfield, I was not supervising them. I was not with
Lorsqu'ils
them.
Ils sont revenus sur le chantier, je n'étais pas à leur côté. Je n'étais pas là pour les superviser.
Lorsque vous les supervisiez à l'époque, quand ils coupaient du bois, étiez-vous vous-même armé, puisque vous dites qu'en tant que chauffeur, il vous arrivait de fait de surveiller ces travailleurs.
You would have to watch over these workers.
Answer. Yes, there was a rifle in each vehicle.
Il y avait un fusil so we had de
one rifle with us in the
Nous
one vehicle.
Fusil par véhicule.
The rifle was given to us to in order that we
Ce
could use to find any meat in the forest.
Au cas où nous rencontrerions des ennemis dans la forêt.
And we never used that rifle to kill
Mais
anyone of the workers, but we used it to go and find wild meat.
C'est lorsque nous partions chasser le gibier que l'on l'utilisait.
And as I stated earlier, so my colleagues with me also had rifles, and because
dit,
I was familiar with the location, I was the one who led the group. And again, there was a rifle in the one vehicle.
Il y avait un fusil par véhicule.
President, it is now convenient time for a short break, so we will take
the
break from now until 3:05. Court officer, please facilitate a proper room for this witness, and please invite him back to the courtroom at 3:05. The court is now in recess.
Something after.